I spoke with Tyre's mother and expressed my condolences and told her that I was going to be making the case to the Congress that should pass the George Floyd Act. We should get this under control. I can only do so much in an executive order at a federal level. And the prayer, I was really pleased that she called for no peaceful protest, no violence, no movement at all. And so I spoke with her about, 10, 15 minutes. And
are you going to visit Poland next month?
About the violence and the potential.
Well, I am. I'm obviously very concerned about it, but I think she has made a very strong plea. She's obviously in enormous pain. She talked about, as you heard her when she spoke publicly, but she also talked about how she didn't know what she was going to do. And I told her that I told her I had some idea of what that loss was like, and that although it's impossible to believe now, the time will come when his memory brings a smile before a tear. And she says she already is thinking about what he would want her to do, which is very positive.
So, what is at stake tonight, sir, with the nation watching this videotape and what could happen? What is at stake?
What's at stake is, first of all, innocent people lives, number one. Number two, it has a lot to say and do with the image of America. It has a lot to do with whether or not we are the country we say we are, that we're a country of law and order and means by which we can peacefully protest and let the courts make the judgment.